Hello everyone, today we will discuss one more important topic of thorax, that is the right atrium. Now first of all let's talk about the right atrium's location. This is the right atrium. Now the venous blood from the right atrium will go into the right ventricle by passing through a tricuspid valve. Now the venous blood from the right ventricle will go into the pulmonary artery or pulmonary trunk and then will reach up to the lungs where it will be get oxygenated. Now it mainly forms the right border of the heart, part of the upper border of the heart. Now the heart has mainly two surfaces, that is the sternocostal surface and the diaphragmatic surface. Now what are these two surfaces? Sternocostal surface is this surface, the anterior surface we can say, which is visible from the outside, which is visible from the outside part. While the diaphragmatic surface is actually the inferior surface, or we can say the surface which is visible from the posterior view of the heart. So the right atrium forms the sternocostal surface of the heart and also the base of the heart. Now the external features of the right atrium. Now the elongated vertical part of the right atrium receives superior vena cava from the upper side and the inferior vena cava from the lower side. Now what is sulcus terminalis? The right border has shallow vertical groove that actually passes from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava. Okay, so that is actually sulcus terminalis. That means why the sulcus terminalis is not visible in this diagram, because this is actually an open cut heart. Okay, this where the right atrium is actually exposed. Okay, but the sulcus terminalis is actually present in the outer surface. So that's why it is not visible in the diagram. But the sulcus terminalis is actually present in the outer surface. Now the crista terminalis. The sulcus terminalis is formed by the internal muscular ridge. Okay. And that is the crista terminalis. That means the crista terminalis is actually the inner muscular ridge of the sulcus terminalis. Simple. Now the SA node or the pacemaker of the heart is actually located in the upper part of the sulcus terminalis and also known as the pacemaker of the heart. Now the right atrioventricular groove, it is actually a groove which separates the right atrium from the right ventricle. So somewhere here the right atrioventricular groove will be present, and it mainly lodges two things, the right coronary artery and the small cardiac vein. Now let's talk about the auricle of the right atrium. What is auricle? Auricle is actually the right atrium's upper part, which is prolonged into the left part. That means the right atrium is prolonged towards the left side of the heart. That is the right auricle. Now the auricle actually covers the roof of the ascending aorta. Now this is the ascending aorta. So it will cover the roof of the ascending aorta. And it partly overlaps the infundibulum of the right ventricle. Now the marginal notch of the right atrium and the internal spongy part of the right atrium actually allows the free blood flow from it. Now tributaries of the vessel which actually opens into the right atrium are the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, coronary sinus. What is this? Coronary sinus is actually the largest vein of the heart which opens into the right atrium. Now the anterior cardiac vein. This vein is actually 3 to 4 in number, which is present actually on the right ventricle but opens into the right atrium. So there's no difference. It actually present in the right ventricle but opens into the right atrium. Vena cordis minimus, which are very small, numerous valveless veins which are present in almost all the four chambers of the heart and opens into that particular cavity. And the last is the right marginal vein. Now the internal features of the right atrium, these are mainly three: the smooth posterior part or known as the sinus venarum, the rough anterior part or the pectinate, and the third is the interatrial septum. We'll talk about all these three in detail in particular. Okay, now first let's talk about the smooth posterior part or the sinus venarum part. Now over here the location of sinus venarum is this. As you can see, this is the sinus venarum or the smooth posterior part of the right atrium. Now embryologically it is derived from the right horn of the sinus venosus. Now, almost all the tributaries actually opens in the smooth posterior part of the right atrium except the anterior cardiac vein. Now we'll discuss all the tributaries in detail. First of all, superior vena cava opens into the smooth posterior part from the upper part. Then the inferior vena cava, which actually opens from the lower part and actually guarded by the Eustachian valve. Eustachian valve mainly in the adults, while during the embryological life, this Eustachian valve is actually rudimentary and it actually directs the flow of the blood from the right atrium towards the left atrium. Now, the coronary sinus. The coronary sinus, actually, I told you, is the largest vein of the heart and opens between the inferior vena cava valve. This is the inferior vena cava valve and the atrioventricular orifice. This is the AV orifice. So, it will open between these two things. Now, the opening is actually guarded by the Thebesian valve. Thebesian valve guards the opening of the coronary sinus. Now, the vena cordis minimus, also known as Thebesian vein, is actually present in all the four chambers of the heart and also in the right atrium and will open directly into it. Now, the intravenous tubercle of lower. This is actually a very small projection scarcely visible on the posterior wall of the right atrium just below the opening of the superior vena cava. This superior vena cava, so just below its opening, there will be intravenous tubercle of lower. Now, what it actually specifies or denotes? It actually denotes a particular thing of the embryonic life. What happens during the embryonic life? This intravenous tubercle of lower actually directs the superior vena cava blood to the right ventricle. Okay, so this intravenous tubercle of lower will direct the superior vena cava blood towards the right ventricle. So don't get confused. The Eustachian valve will direct the blood during the embryonic life from the right atrium to the left atrium, where the intravenous tubercle of lower will direct the superior vena cava blood into the right ventricle during the embryonic life. Now, the rough anterior or the pectineate part of the right atrium. Now, embryologically, it is derived from the primitive atrial chamber. Now, in this diagram, this over here, you can see this is the rough anterior part of the pectineate part of the right atrium. Now, in this, it has a series of transverse muscular ridge called as the musculi pectinati. That's why its name is pectinate part, because it has musculi pectinati muscles. Now, this muscle actually arises from the crista terminalis. I told you before, what is that? Crista terminalis is actually muscular ridge, which actually goes from the superior vena cava towards the inferior vena cava. So, it will arise from the crista terminalis and will go in the forward and downward direction towards the atrioventricular orifice, and it will look like tooth of comb. Now, in the right atrium, okay, all this musculi pectinate muscle will interconnect with each other and they will form a reticular network over there, means in the right auricle. Till now, whatever diagram I have shown to you, they are difficult to draw in exams, but they are easy to understand while studying. So, you can refer this diagram for study purpose only. While to draw in the exams, I will suggest you one diagram in the end so that you can draw this diagram easily in the exams. So, in the end of this video, you will get one diagram to draw in the exams. Now, the last part, that is the interatrial septal part. Now, the location, it will be somewhere here in between the two atriums of the heart, means between the right atrium and the left atrium, it will separate these two chambers of the heart. Now, in the embryological life, they derive from the septum primum and septum secundum. Now, we have mainly two things over here, fossa ovalis and the annulus ovalis or the limbus fossa ovalis. First of all, let's look at these two. This is the fossa ovalis, and at the upper border of the fossa ovalis, there will be annulus ovalis or the limbus fossa ovalis, and the annulus ovalis is actually deficient in the inferior border of the fossa ovalis. Now, first of all, what is fossa ovalis? Fossa ovalis is actually a shallow depression or saucer-shaped depression at the lower part of the right atrium, and this is actually derived from the septum primum. Just remember this, it is derived from the septum primum. Now, if you talk about the annulus ovalis or the limbus fossa ovalis, they are actually The prominent margin of the fossa ovalis, especially at the upper border of it and also on the sides, but they're deficient on the at the inferior border of the fossa ovalis. And one more important thing is the annulus ovalis, they're derived from the free lower edge of the septum secundum. So in short, we can say that the fossa ovalis is derived from the septum primum and the annulus ovalis is derived from the septum secundum. Okay, now finally, this is the diagram that you can draw in the exam. This is a very easy diagram and almost all the important things are covered in this diagram. This is a crista terminalis, that means run from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava, muscular pectinati. This is fossa ovalis, its upper border annulus fossa ovalis. This is the opening of the vena cordis minimis, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. This is a tricuspid valve, valve of coronary sinus, that means Thibetian valve. And this is the right auricle. So this diagram you can draw easily in exams. So this was all about right atrium. Hope you understood it well. Thank you so much.